So you learn what it's like to be in different cultures, to be humble and hardworking. It's Franz to start it off. Franziska sets it up with that serve. His short game is incredibly strong. One of the tallest players in the game, only out-heightened by Stefan Mengel, his teammate, and a few others. Edge of the table for Franziska here. I think another thing that makes these players so kind and humble is they realize on any given day their opponent could beat them, even if that opponent is outside of the top 200 in the world. We've seen it before. The women's side, 150-something, beats world number one. Ayika Mukherjee.
4-0.
Patrick Franziska with a flawless start so far. That short stroke backhand.
That's it, 5-0.
Clever idea. And it pays off. Here's the thing. When you're as powerful as Patrick Franziska is in the attacking game, and you move in like that, Wang Chunting has to be concerned about a quick attack. And when the ball's dropped short, to get there on time, not easy.
Zero, 7.
I have my thoughts about Franz and trying to save the production team some time after that long match. Look at the angle here. Until game one is finished, and until the match is finished, we have no idea how long this match will be. So the bagel still existing for Wang Chunting. Oh, the backhand like that to set up 10 game points?
10.
If you have to worry about a backhand like that, this is an audition for the Olympics right now. Ooh, the finisher.
1-10.
In case you wondered if there would be a mercy point, look at this, the exact opposite. Almost wins it with a lucky net and perfectly placed the follow-up to save a game point, but only that one, 11-1.
11-1.
Domination to Patrick Franziska. Each nation or each team can send no more than two players to play singles.
0-1.
And if you're Team Germany, you've got the European champion leading the team, Dong Qiu.
1-1.
You've got a player who won the bronze medal in two of his last three appearances, Dmitry Ovtrov. You've got Timo Boll, the legend, four-time world number one.
2-1.
Who recently beat Zhang Wujin, Tomokazu Harimoto, and Lin Wenru. And you've got Patrick Franziska. These are your four choices.
2-2.
At least the four main ones, the ones who stand out. Germany with Benedikt Duda, Ruben Fielus, and others not far behind. Drying the hand on the table, as players will, between towel breaks.
Two, three.
Two. Nice recovery after the flick and the follow-up edge attack. Franz not bothered. Little side spin on the first short stroke. The way he gets low, both knees really had to bend for this follow-up shot. Awkward ball. Still pulls there with the core. Brings the elbow in and spins it to the short side.
5-2.
Franz on the serve, back in front. Better start this time around for Wang Chunting, but still an even better start for Franz.
2-6.
Little look at the difference in service success here. 1 out of every 5 for Wang Chunting. 9 out of every 10.
3-6.
Obviously, that changes with that point, but coming into that, it's an interesting statistic there, and it seems to match the score line we saw from game one. Long pushed, used perfectly
seven,
here.
7-3.
4-point lead once again for France. Now, I mentioned that I'd give you the specifics of their head-to-head because France has been in form.
Left. 7-3.
Last time they played, it was Patrick Franziska who won 3-1 at the Singapore Smash 2022.
8-3.
The last two times before that were Wang Chunting, and that was 2018 and 2019, so quite some time has passed.
3-9.
Actually, the last time they played was at the event, if I'm not mistaken. T2 Diamond Malaysia. Wang Chunting had a big ankle injury that year at a T2 event against Shuxing. Just amazing. The recovery and the feeling of Patrick Franziska. He's constantly putting it where Wang Chunting doesn't want. And no more game points needed. 11-3. Another dominant game. Drying the forehead on the sleeves, back to serve. Game three, it's France. Much better rally here. Wang Chunting getting in with the backhands, taking away the heavy topspin of France, not getting quite the wrist action that he had in the first two games. The top edge of the racket here. I can tell you, having blocked or tried to block for Wang Chunting before, his backhand openers are incredibly spinny. And they have a lot of side spin on them with their top spin, which makes the ball really move.
2-0. Left. 2-0.
A good push here to come out on top. France getting his first point on the receive, both players so far. Winning points only on receive. But the pattern's changed with the low spinning shot.
1-3.
Change of pace here, Wang Chunting getting creative. Very low to the net, arcing shot. Dips, dives shallow. Finesse that Franz comes in with for these pushes, the way he just cradles the ball, puts a little side spin on it, caresses the outside. It's sweet, really. Wang Chunting with his racket high is able to deflect the first one. And then as Franz is recovering from his own speed, it buys a little bit more time for Wang Chunting to accelerate. He moves him into the elbow, as you would see someone do against a taller player. 24 of the last 32 for Patrick Franziska. But if we zoom in, Wang Chunting with the momentum now.
5-2.
Little break there. Once the racket is out of the control of your hand, it doesn't matter if it hits and makes the ball. I guess the hope is that it's still in your fingertips, but there is no table tennis review right now.
4-6.
Meaning we have humans making calls. We've got the best in the world at making calls, international umpires. In Singapore, we had gold badge umpires. Blue badge used to be the top tier. Still incredibly hard to get that.
2-7.
This is good use of the table as an obstacle. Wang Chunting leaving it in an awkward position, saying, hey, France, you can take the attack, but dodge the back corner of the table if you're gonna take a full swing.
Now,
just the same, using the table as an obstacle. Flick brings him in and keeps the pressure on. 2-0. This is a completely different game. The power has been taken away.
It
hasn't been easy. Patrick Franziska was up 10-0 in game one.
2-10.
Talk about finding your rhythm and finding your confidence. Wang Chunting right now has found ways to keep Franz guessing in every moment inside the table. Serves, receives, short game. 8 game points for the Hong Konger.
3-10.
One game point saved, 7 more to go. Cracking backhand, carries long, and 11-3. Wang Chunting returns the favor. Penhold grip has pros and cons. We don't see so many players playing that grip anymore.
0-1.
But you can only deduce from that the shake hands grip has somewhat more advantage. Even Team China doing the same.
2-0.
Variation in the serve from the spin to the placement. Franz, on the receive before, still able to handle well, make quick decisions. That's the Franz that only allowed 4 points between the first 2 games. Timeout called.
Timeout.
For Wang Chunting, it sounded like a lot of confidence in the receive game. Don't be afraid to push, but as soon as you have the opportunity, don't be afraid to spin either.
1-3.
It's been a big part of it, but the placement of that receive, Wang Chunting getting his first point out of the timeout.
Two, three.
Despite Cantonese being the main language for a long time, there's been a rise of Mandarin spoken in Hong Kong. It's a very awkward ball. Sounds like it came
three,
off the
three.
Of Patrick Franziska. Wang Chunting still able to read it perfectly. Catching it on its way down. Had a long way to go to step around and play that forehand. Generally the preferred shot to play against a high ball, forehand.
Left. 3-3.
Inside the table, playing the safe spin shot with the placement here. Franz. The much needed point to stop the streak after 3 in a row from Wang Chunting's timeout. Cracking backhand does it.
3-5.
Remember, Wang Chunting in a must-win situation. Every game for the rest of this match, managed to pull out the third.
Four, five.
Now from a points standpoint, I talked about exponential growth. 15 points to the loser of this match. 6 times that to the winner. And that's if they stop in the round of 16. 15 points now. The round of 16 earns you 90, then 175, and it keeps doubling. Until from the finals, if you win the finals instead of 700, you get 1,000 points. World rankings, points expire every year.
6-5.
So that's why you see all the top players who can typically playing. Wang Chuqin taking a rest right now after accomplishing the world number one spot.
5-7.
Beautiful pull of that right leg as we go into a towel break. Keep your eyes on Franz. Just pulls back that right leg a little bit. There's another angle at it. See it dip there to create a little bit of space. Often happens when someone plays the ball at your right hip and you choose to go forehand. 5 serving 7.
Come on!
Come on,
five,
indeed.
Eight.
Franz getting that free backhand in. It's so fluid. Bruce Lee was the Hong Konger. But being water, Patrick Franziska. Beautiful save there as Wang Chunting plays it down the line. Open racket face. That one, the punch. Practicing his control as the ball carries long. Point over as soon as the ball misses the table, which it already had.
9-6.
2 points away from the round of 16. Patrick Franziska with another serve here. Chance to set up 4 match points. Combination play hits him in the hip, right in the pocket. And now 4 match points for Patrick Franziska. Pendulum and then the placement after bringing Wang Chunting in over the table. Wide angles and Wang Chunting from way back manages to counter. Heavy top spin shot to save a match point. Check it out from this camera angle. Racket behind the head twice. Not an easy place to win a point from. 3 match points left.
Left. 7-10.
Oh, the arcing spin shot catches 11, the edge. Bronze. Okay. In all fairness, outplayed Wang Chunting. Wang Chunting picked up in game.